Hey guys, welcome to another video tutorial. So today we're going to play this week's event, which is the Nightmare Missions. We're going to use Flak, and I think we can do a marathon for this one. So first we're going to start with Nightmare Mission 1. Alright, so just for the benefit of me having it easy for this tutorial, because it's too difficult to focus playing while talking at the same time, so I'm going to use my best tower mods. So basically, in my own opinion, the most efficient towers here in the map are the lasers. You could probably use MGs, because I've tried it before, and you could use a combo of lasers and rockets, but the most practical approaches are the lasers, specifically the quad beams, because this map built with a lot of winding paths, and based on my own experience, lasers are always better for winding paths compared to rockets and MGs. So my preference for tower mods are laser damage, fire rate, and build cost. I could also use a laser range mod, but for me, I think using build costs could upgrade your towers as quickly as you can, and you could build even more numbers. So more towers are always stronger than just upgraded in range. Alright, so I think we are ready. Let's start the game. Alright, so if you see here, again, what I was telling you about, a lot of winding paths. So towers like these, for these areas right here, there's a hard curve there. The good thing about quad beams is basically they can shoot a maximum of 5 laser beams, and they can spread the laser beams in a 360 direction. So if you have a MG here, it does more damage, but if you notice, for example, for the shotgun, it has a very slow rotating speed. That means it couldn't cope up with fast enemies. And this map is built with very fast enemies, so the right strategy here are the lasers. Now we're going to find those key areas where we're going to build first. So I believe this is the key area for the game where the first quad beam should be positioned, and then we will focus on this one next. Okay. So on the start of the game, I'd like to position Flak here just so he could get those skills. The first skill right away. Flak has an interesting final skill, which is the Bounty Hunter, which doubles your energy per kill. So the strategy here is basically hit and run. You have to keep Flak alive as long as possible, and you need to steal some kills from the tower just so you could hasten up your energy building, and you could build faster towers faster. Alright, let's start the game. Here we go. So that's how easy to kill the basic creeps here, the grunts. So I'm gonna move Flak a little bit and throw that grenade, shoot, escape the acid spit, kill another one. I'm gonna transfer into the left side. So basically for this mission, in wave 1, the left side is usually the left side is the stronger side, so that's where you want Flak to be. Alright, build another laser there. If you notice, trying to steal some kills. I'm gonna start upgrading this one. There you go. So that's double kill each time I get to kill one creep. Or one creep. That's it, see. Try to avoid the laser, the shielded ones. They take a lot of effort to kill. Just gonna add one laser here just as an insurance. Okay, we're gonna be upgrading this one to quad beam soon. You might want to target the weaker creeps as well when you're using flak, like those yellow ones, because they're basically easy money. I mean, they probably don't, they're not worth as much as the shielded ones, but at least you can, the goal is just to get energy as fast as you can. Alright, we're ready for this one. Okay, now that we have a quad beam on the left side, we can start building the right side. So our next goal here is to strengthen the right side. We're going to prepare for wave 4. Okay, we're ready to go to the next wave. Where wave 4 is basically where the threat comes, where the massive threat starts, where the flying creeps and the juggernauts start coming out. And wave 4 is basically the most crucial wave in this game. If you notice as well, in wave 3, the right side doesn't produce the basic creeps, they're only tunnel worms. So if you are flak, ignore the right side, because basically these tunnel worm offsprings don't give you energy. They're basically useless when you kill them, and your towers are strong enough to take care of them. So you want flak to keep generating energy. That's why you have to focus him on the left side right here. That's all right. It's okay. There you go. We can call the next wave now. So that's my cable as well. Right. We need to start preparing for those flyers. There they are. Remember to target them first. They're quite annoying. By the way, for you guys that don't know, I'm not pressing on flak directly when I'm commanding him, but rather I'm pressing on his image at the bottom. That makes it quicker. Okay, we might have to use some of that there. These guys are too near. Okay, we're ready to call the next wave. Okay, that's extra money for us. We're gonna start building on the left side, because there will be creeps coming on the left side as well. So now both sides are equally threatening. So the goal for flak is to balance the tower build. Okay, that's a good throw actually. So these guys are almost dying here. Let flak kill them. Just so you double your energy, that's it, good. the night scale. So always check on the juggernaut with the low health, because they will stop attacking and just keep charging once their health runs low. Okay, let's start building some towers here as well. This one is a key area. Good job. So we can start killing this behemoth as well. We can catch it. Right. We can call the next wave now. I think our towers are too strong. Like to handle them. So if you think that they're passing your defenses, upgrade to Caustic Cloud. It doesn't look much, but it does deal damage, good damage in the long run. So now we're in wave 6, this is probably an easier wave now. All I have to do is just keep building lasers, just for fun. So my goal is to just build lasers and all of these tower slots. I'm gonna put it here first, because this one, well, there's still enemies coming from this side right here. One more laser here, just so I can purchase all the tower slots for... Ta-da! And that's it! That's it. We finished the first wave with a perfect score. Alright, let's proceed to the next challenge. Alright guys, what do you think? Leave a comment if you have anything to say.